Hey guys, I'm back with some World of Warships content again. And what better ship to continue our journey on the American tech tree with than the USS St. Louis at Tier 3. This ship is an absolute blast to play, quite literally. And while you don't get any hard upgrades this tier either, you won't feel helpless in the battles for sure. But before we check out the reasons for that, let me just advise those who are only interested in the gameplay that I have a timestamp for you in the description below. It will lead you to a game where I managed to scrape together 47,000 damage in a Tier 5 game. So first of all, what was the St. Louis like in real life? Well, this was in fact the lead ship of her class of protected cruisers in the US Navy, being launched in 1905 and commissioned in 1906. During her service time, before and during the First World War, she was decommissioned and recommissioned a few times, spent some time in reserve fleets, and did her duty by mainly escorting convoys and acting as a transport ship for troops. Eventually, the St. Louis was finally decommissioned in 1922 to be sold off for scrap in 1930. While her history might not be as exciting as a lot of the other ships, in-game it will see a lot more action guaranteed. So what can you expect from it? Well, mainly guns. Lots and lots of guns. I mean, just look at it. Fully upgraded, it has exactly 40 guns of some sort. It pretty much looks like a hedgehog that did grow guns on its back. This is definitely the most distinct feature of this ship, and it feels just right pumping salvo after salvo into the enemy ships. You have now 40 main batteries on your ship, one of them located in your front and one in your rear, and 6 on each side. This means that fully aimed, you will be unleashed salvos of 8 towards your enemy, which is a much better feeling than the 4 maximum shots per salvo you have been used to up until now on the American cruiser line. The drawback is that these are exactly the same guns you did use on the Chester as well, so the only upgrade you get really in firepower is the sheer amount of shells you can unload. As you can fire a salvo of 8 every 7.5 seconds, this is not to be underestimated. As for the secondary stats, you have now an increased firing range up to 10.4 km away, a slightly worse accuracy at 105 meters, and the exact same turning speed where the guns can do a 180 degree turn in just in 22.5 seconds. You also still only have a 7% chance to set the enemy on fire with HE shells, so don't expect miracles on this front. Your secondary armament is quite formidable now as well, with a total of 18 76mm guns. However, as they have a range of only 2.5 km, by the time they engage the enemy you are probably in big trouble already. The same goes for the AA guns as well, where you have 8 7.6mm guns mounted on the ship, with a maximal engagement distance of 0.9 km. This is still not something you should be relying on, that's for sure. We can't be super happy about the other stats either. This ship is slow as a turtle, and with a 22 knots top speed, you are pretty much back to tier 1 level of speeds on the battlefield, while you will encounter a lot of faster enemies, even including higher tier battleships. And they love to jump on St. Louis class ships, as you only have 76mm of armor at best, protected cruiser or not, and you have absolutely no chance outrunning them, making you an easy target for their powerful secondary guns. At least you turn quite well, so try to use that to your advantage and get behind cover, behind islands, to disengage. As for the rest, your health pool at 29,500 is alright at its tier, but don't expect it to hold up much if you have something nasty like a tier 5 Congo, for example, shooting at you. You can also expect to be detected already from 11 km away on sea and from 6.3 km away from the air. Upgrade-wise, it's quite straightforward, and I would not advise to skimp on any of it once again. Your hull upgrade gives you 4 extra main guns, all your AA guns, and a nice 2200 HP increase. Your gun upgrade, while you already start with the 152mm MK6, gives you an increase in rate of fire and turning speed. And finally, the gunfire control system gives you, as usual, a 10% increase on your firing range. So what's the St. Louis like? It's fun with its rate of fire, but it's not without some serious flaws. You will shoot at a lot of better armored opponents, so expect a lot of your shells to fail to penetrate, and your HE shells won't cause a crazy amount of fires either. You are also really slow, and can get outmaneuvered quite easily, so you have to be extra vigilant with your sailing. Still, it has potential. And I hope to show you exactly that in the next game we are about to jump into. Alright. So here we are in the St. Louis, and this will be an encounter battle, unfortunately, like mostly against tier 4 and 5 opponents, so thank you matchmaking once again. But that's alright, we have enough guns to deal with these guys, just have to be very very careful with our sailing, cause if we get ourselves out of position, they will make mincemeat out of us instantly. So, the master plan is to try and engage the cruisers and destroyers as much as we can and avoid the battleships. Both teams have two Langleys, so aircraft carriers on their side, and three battleships each. Mostly tier 4 Miyogis and I think one Kongo. So those guys will pretty much be busy with each other, and hopefully in the meantime we can get away and unloading a lot of salvos into the other guys. Now, to do that, I will actually eventually switch to AP. I will try to ignore the HE shells at the time being, cause I will try to focus on the cruisers and, to be honest, with St. Louis 7% chance of fire with HE shells, it's not really impressive. So we will try to stick to AP, see what kind of damage we can do with salvos of 8 that we can unleash. So what I will try to do is to sail up and down here behind the this line of islands and take shots on the enemy ships appearing in between the islands. Hopefully giving them a limited amount of time to fire on me. And also allowing my teammates, especially the battleships, to be in the first line, rather than myself presenting as a nice, fat, juicy target. I definitely have to watch out for planes as well. The enemy Langleys should be focused on our battleships as a priority, but we will try not to look too appetizing, just in case. So there is a lot of derping around going on in this sector, it seems. Everybody's trying to figure out where to go, and definitely don't want to push ahead in between the islands. There are too many ugly battleships coming this way anyway. Well, one of the battleships, but a lot of the cruisers. Okay, so we have firing range of about 10.4-ish, I think, kilometers, so it's starting to get into range on a couple of these ships. You can see the some of the guys already taking fire. The battleships have a huge firing range, but they are miraculously inaccurate. Alright, so first salvo out, and I probably just realized about this time that I loaded HE, so now I switch to AP. Stupid. Anyway, let's see what kind of damage we can do, and I think... Oh yes, he's firing definitely on us. So no, that was a complete miss, we have to re-aim a bit. So the main aim is to try to keep the line in line with the ship's hull. And judging by the speed, I think this is about the correct firing range. Let's see where the shots land. In the middle of the ship, that's quite alright. And in the meantime, we also try to turn a little bit here and there, trying to avoid his fire. And look at the damage he takes. 3-4 hits per salvo is really not bad. Well, if you manage to do some damage, so I'm doing damage between 1500 to 3000 damage per salvo. And as I said, I do about 500, but that's alright. And that ship is about to go down. And there we go, we don't get the final shot, but that was some really good damage done, 19 hits scored. So let's see who's next. There is a battleship coming over in that part of the map. So what the plan is here, I will keep on sailing, slightly to lean towards port side, and I will try to get cover behind this part of the map on the sixth line, as I will turn around to come back again. Oh, there is an enemy cruiser as well, so we will try to switch fire here. Well, that was not a bad damage on the battleship either, and it seems they probably rammed each other successfully. Alright, so definitely cruiser first. Aiming is not perfect, but that's not a bad hit. And oh, there is a destroyer. Definitely want to get some of that. But first, one more salvo into this battleship before he disappears behind the island. It's not really a good hit, and I don't really know what I'm thinking here. Probably something around the line of derp. Alright, so there is a enemy cruiser taking some shots at us. We can't have that. That was a complete miss. A country mine. I think this one will be better. Yep. Alright, and smoke screen is up. We have to watch out for the destroyer. He is in a smoke screen. We are probably his main target now, so have to expect torpedoes incoming. Alright, let's take out this cruiser. Well, not like this, obviously. Reposition. Salvo is out. It's better, still need to adjust. Look at the damage we are doing. Oh, torpedoes. Luckily it was a miss. Alright, we have to nail this guy. We are taking a lot of damage here. And think we got him. Just have to turn as well too. And I have to turn, unfortunately, port side, because I was too close to the island. Which means the number of guns I can point at him is rather limited, but we got him anyway. Unfortunately, gets a few more shots into us with his last salvo. Well, it's not a bad result. We are on 56 hits at the moment. We sunk one ship. So now it's time to turn around, join the fleet. This side of the map is completely empty. It is a missed torpedo salvo from that bloody destroyer. As we fire blind. But very little chance of that actually hitting anything. He is small and very fast. So definitely it's time to go back, rejoin the fleet. Sailing around here completely alone is a recipe for disaster. Let's join the battleships, who are all derping around in that corner of the map. And hopefully we won't run any trouble in between. Look at the state of this poor St. Louis. Jesus. It's not much holding it together at this stage. There is that bloody destroyer once again. I have to admit, destroyers are something I still have to learn, because I completely suck in them. Cruisers, I like. Battleships, yeah, getting there. The aircraft carriers, yeah, that's the good stuff. I really like that. I still have to sit down and learn the manual aiming to be really effective with them, but I think it's a lot of fun. It's so different. Alright, there is one battleship trying to cap, so he is probably being shot at the moment from all the others. Oh, that's not looking good. We are down 8-5. So let's take some shots at this battleship. So interrupting the cap. There we go. We will get some points for that as well. But we have to make sure we don't get any closer and he's sailing in this direction, and if his secondary guns will engage us, that's probably the end of us. But before that, let's see if we can get some damage of this encounter. And it's definitely too close. He's now coming for us. He doesn't have to waste any shots with his main batteries. Secondary armament will do just fine. Yep, there we go. We are taking fire. Look at the amount of hits he's taking. Yeah, he's not taking much damage. Probably now would have been a good time to load some HE. We are just picking away on him. He's now out of the gap. And we pulled back one back, but we will be down very, very soon. He's taking shot after shot after shot. Need some help here, guys. Come on. And oh, torpedo bombers. Are they really going after me? Potentially, this looks very much like it. Well, if they do, that's actually a win, because I'm now pretty much dead, and if they don't shoot the battleships... Yes! They are unloading torpedoes on me, but I'm pretty much dead at this stage anyway, so I don't care, I just want some more shots off. So that's good. That's one run wasted on a pretty much dead St. Louis anyway. They now have to go back and reload, so that means a bit more breathing space for our carrier and battleship, but this battle is over. Anyway, we are down 6 them. So let's see how this battle unfolds. So that's the Tier 4 Miyogi. It's not a bad ship. Still have to unlock it myself. And these guys are doing some damage as well. Yeah, we pulled back one more. It's now 7-10. But this is still very ugly. It would be, of course, nice if they could give a hard time to the enemy. Let's not make it easy for them. In the meantime, look at the graphics. This looks fantastic. Honestly, sometimes I just like to watch the replays. It looks absolutely gorgeous. In the meantime, I don't know where the guns of this battleship are pointing, but it's not the right direction, that's for sure. And look at how slowly the guns are turning, and now he realized, oh, there is actually a cruiser right next to me, perfectly in my line of fire, so again, he's turning the guns a bit late, but forward guns are already in position. He should be shortly also in the range of his secondary guns, so come on, take this guy out, please. And there go the secondary guns. Although we have to say that the accuracy at this stage of the secondary guns is quite bad. Ooh, torpedoes. That was close. Okay. Come on, finish him off. That's the spirit. Look at the amount of damage he takes only from the secondary guns. And look at how inaccurate they are at the same time. It's just spraying all over the place. And it's already within 4 kilometers and still. It's just the accuracy. And this Myogi is dead. We could not even get that cruiser. It's quite unfortunate. This battleship will make mincemeat out of us very, very shortly, and again, the guns are pointing in the wrong direction. But they were also turning in the wrong direction until now, so that's a mistake. Come on, get a good salvo off. But no, doesn't look like it. And just to add insult to injury, they also managed to crash into each other. For the love of God. Ah well. This was always going to go down this way, I guess. At least can the carrier protect himself from the torpedoes? Let's see. Does it work like that? Yes, it does! Carrier protected! But yeah, that carrier is an awful situation. There's no way he's getting out of that one alive. He's taking fire from all the possible directions. I got off another bombing squad. Those are dive bombers. I still have to try them out. I did hear that torpedo bombers are much better than the dive bombers. And oh shit. Oh yes, that did hurt. And yeah, even secondary batteries will just take the ship apart. And the enemy battleship did actually run aground while so very much focused on destroying this independence. And there we go. Yeah, quite an unfortunate end to the game. But I think we did our share of the damage. Let's see how we actually did in terms of... Oh yeah, that's actually not bad. And yeah, it seems that in the top three, despite it being a tier 5 match, there's two of the level 3s that did the most damage. And look at the amount of ships that we did hit. And we caused 47,000 damage in a tier 5 game. It's not bad. It's not bad at all. We had 120 hits, and it scored 63 penetrations out of those, so... It's quite unfortunate. Think about the damage potential we would have had if we would have been higher tier. So that was my little review on the St. Louis. Quite a little gun collection, but I think I'm ready for the real upgrade. If you did like the video, please consider rating or sharing it. It will help a lot. Next up, we will have a look at the T-Raid Premium Heavy Tank, the T-34 in World of Tanks. And then we are back on the seas looking at some carrier play with the USS Langley at Tier 4. Take care, guys, and I see you on the battlefield.